Welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for watching. In this video, I'm doing a makeup tutorial on this makeup look right here. It is a teal halo eye with a pop of shimmer. I really just sat down today and decided to wing it. I was really inspired by this Dream Street palette by ColourPop in collaboration with Kathleen Lights. Kathleen Lights is one of my favorite YouTubers ever. I absolutely adore her, and she is such an inspiration to me. And I was really excited to get her palette, and I've been using it for like natural everyday makeup looks, but I wanted to try something different and kind of step out of my comfort zone and use this blue color right here called Potion. And I really like the way that it came out, but you guys, this palette overall is just so beautiful, and I'll link it down below. But it's really affordable and the colors are amazing, the pigmentation is amazing, and I just really can't say enough good things about it. I've been using it for a couple weeks now, like every single day, and I love it. So I wanted to kind of be bold and see what I could come up with, and this is the makeup look that I filmed today. So I really hope that you guys like it, and if you want to see how I did it, then please keep on watching. Okay, since we are doing a heavy eye look today, I'm going to start by doing my eyes first, just so that way if there's any fallout from the shadow, I can easily clean that up before moving on to my foundation. So to prime my eyes, I'm using my concealer. I'm using the Tarte Shape Tape Concealer. I will link everything that I use in this video down below, like always. But I like to pick this up on a damp beauty blender and blend it out all over my eyelids. This just gets rid of my veins or any discoloration I have, just to give us a clean slate to work with. So I like to put that down and then set it with my Laura Mercier Translucent Setting Powder. This just gives us a nice base for the shadow. Okay, I'm going right into the beautiful Dream Street palette. The first thing that I'm going to do is grab my big fluffy blending brush, and I'm picking up this color Stardust, and I'm going to put this all over my crease, and this is going to act as my transition shade. After I blend that out, I realized I wanted to deepen it up a little bit, so I'm picking up the color right next to it called Twinkle. I'm doing the same exact thing, just blending it out very lightly. This look is all about the blending. Right after my crease, I'm picking up Potion, the super pretty teal color, and I'm using a dense pencil brush to place this on the outer V of my lid and the inner corner of my lid. And it's gonna look crazy at first, but I just like to do it this way because I can be very specific with where I place the product, and then I can blend it out later, and it just makes it a lot easier. So now once the product is placed where I want it, I'm using my blending brush to smooth it out, make sure it's not so harsh. I like to take my time with this because blending is everything. So to give this eye look a halo effect, I want that teal shadow to mesh and meet in the crease. So to help me do this, I'm picking up the transition shades from earlier and blending them together. I also want to warm up the look a little, so I took the color Water Bear and put that into my crease as well. For my lid, I took this flat brush and sprayed it with my Smashbox Primer Water. Wetting your eyeshadow brush when using a shimmery shadow will give off almost a foiled wet effect, and it also helps the glitter stick, so I highly recommend doing this. The color that I'm using is called Mermaid Boy, and it's super gorgeous. I'm packing this all over the center of my lid and just building it up. Picking up my fluffy blending brush again, just to smooth out any harsh lines. And now that the lid is done, I grabbed Potion again to darken it up since Mermaid Boy tried to take over. Now to really define the crease and the halo shape, I'm using a small flat brush
in the color Mooney, which is like a chocolate brown, and I'm just carving out the crease, and I'm gonna slowly build this up, and then I'm gonna grab a bigger blending brush to smooth it out. To highlight my brow bone, I'm using the color Elfish. To line my eyes, I'm using an angled brush and just a black eyeshadow. I'm keeping it very close to my lashes and not winging it out or anything because I want my eyes to appear more round rather than like a cat eye. I'm quickly applying some mascara to my upper lashes before putting on falsies. I'm going to be using the Ardell Demi Wispies. Okay, lashes on, and now I'm going to do my face before finishing off my eyes. So I'm starting by priming my skin using the Smashbox Photo Finish Primer, and I'm just putting this all over my face. For foundation, I'm using the Fit Me Matte and Poreless. You guys know how much I love this foundation, and I'm going to apply it using my damp beauty sponge. Don't forget to take it all down your neck just so that you match. The concealer that I'm using is by LA Girl, and I really like this because it has a peachy undertone, so it's perfect for color correction. My dark circles have been so bad, and I've been reaching for this lately, and it's like $3, so I definitely recommend it. Okay, I don't know about you guys, but I hate having foundation and shit on my lips, so throughout my makeup, I'm constantly wiping them off and applying Vaseline or lip balm or something. Okay, to set down my concealer, I'm using the Laura Mercier Translucent Setting Powder. I'm just lightly dusting it on, and I also like to apply it under where I'm going to be putting my bronzer, just to give my face more shape and definition, and hopefully make my head not look like a basketball. The bronzer that I'm using is the Hoola Bronzer by Benefit. I'm putting it in the huge places, and I'm also going to be going down the sides of my nose to contour it a little bit, as you'll see in a second. For highlight, I'm mixing these beautiful powders in this BH Cosmetics palette in collaboration with Carly Bible, another amazing and affordable palette that I will link down below. Okay, now my face is done, and I'm going to go back and finish out my eyes. So I'm going into the Dream Street palette again, and I'm picking up Water Bear and running it along my lower lash line. Then I'm going to put Potion right on top of it and just blend them out. I'm putting a black eyeshadow into my upper and lower waterline. You can also just use eyeliner, but I always use black eyeshadow. I don't know why, but I don't know if I own a stick eyeliner, but whatever, it works for me, and I really like just using shadow. To highlight my inner corner, I'm using Elfish again. So pretty. And lastly, I wanted to blend Water Bear into my crease because I just felt it needed to be a little darker, and I don't know, after that, I just felt really good about it. I felt like the look was complete. But yeah, I just recommend like working your way up slowly because you can always put color on, but it's harder to take it off. So just slowly build up to the intensity that you like. I'm applying a little more mascara and then the eyes are done. For my lips, I'm using the NYX Liquid Suede Lipsticks. I absolutely love these. There's a wide range of colors that I need to get my hands on, but the one that I'm using here is called Sandstorm. Okay, now I'm just setting everything down using the Maybelline Face Studio Master Fix Wear Boosting Setting Spray. Jeez, could they have picked a longer name? Now I'm just fanning myself. And this is the final look. I really hope that you guys liked it. If you did, please give this video a thumbs up. Please leave me a comment. Let me know what else you guys would like to see. And don't forget to subscribe. I make new videos every week. I will see you guys soon. Bye.